I welcome you all with my love and respects. I welcome all the devotees, disciples, samajis, satsangis from around the world who are sitting with us at this moment in 399 places through NTV and 15 places two-way connection having Nayana Deeksha in 110 cities in 22 countries. Cities having Nayana Deeksha sitting with us are Paris, Toronto, Ohio, UK, Phoenix, Seattle, Los Angeles, Pullman, San Jose, Vancouver, Singapore, Calgary, Oman, and New Zealand. I welcome all of you with my love and respects, and Singapore. There are some more cities which are coming on rotation in two-way connection. I welcome all of you with my love and respects. That's the way we Hindus are. We never bother if somebody hurts us. But we don't keep quiet if our religious sentiments are hurt. See the Indian history. All the rulers, if they enslave people, if they swindle the country, if they grab wealth, if they live a rich life, we don't bother. We hear in the history the French Revolution happened because the queen and the king, they lived in a luxurious way. In India, if some king or queen lives a luxurious way, we won't bother. Have it, who cares? We don't use, if you want to use, from the 5000 years of recorded history, if you see, we don't bother if somebody swindles our wealth. We don't care if they live a luxurious life. But if they touch our religious sentiment, that's all. Aurangzeb, the whole Mughal empire tumbled down, collapsed, just because he started cutting the sacred thread of Brahmins. That's all. We never bothered. When these fellows come and swindle our wealth and take away and live in a luxurious way and put us in poverty, we don't bother. Our religion teaches us to live in poverty. Okay. I don't say to live in poverty, to accept if it is forced on you. We know acceptance. But we don't keep quiet if our religious sentiments are touched. From time immemorial, I can list Aurangzeb. All the empires fallen, collapsed, tumbled down is just because they touched our religious sentiment, our religious sentiments. Same way British. Only when they gave the bullet with a cow's fat covered bullet, the first revolution against the British started. Because cows are sacred for us, it's a religious sentiment. So we revolted. We don't bother if they swindle. But we can't tolerate if the religious sentiments are touched. Let me enter into today's satsang. This 168th sutra, 6th verse, Patanjali's Yoga Sutra. I am continuing the same sutra yesterday, which I was talking. I am continuing on the same sutras which I was talking yesterday, because some more important revelations you need to understand from that sutra. Let me enter into the sutra. Tatra dhyanajam anasayam. Vivekananda translates this sutra as, among the various minds, that which is attained by samadhi is desireless. Swami Prabhavananda translates as, of the various types of mind, only that which is purified by samadhi is freed from all latent impressions of karma and from all cravings. Swami Sachidananda translates as, only the minds born of meditation are free from karmic impressions. Bhagavan Osho translates as, only the original mind which is born of meditation is free from desires. Yesterday, I was talking about the word dhyanajam, born of samadhi, unclutching, meditation. Today, I will take this technical term, the word anasayam. Anasayam means free from impressions. Not only free from impressions, free from possibility of creating any impressions. Patanjali says very beautifully in some other sutra, like a fried seed cannot grow. Same way, when unclutching happens, all the impressions, karma, gets fried. Anashayam, the possibility of impressions does not exist. Please understand. It is not disrespecting now the cosmic presence. Please understand, all your desire is disrespecting the cosmic presence. Why do you desire? Because you don't feel the cosmos is constantly supporting you. That's the reason the desire. You don't feel you are being showered. The ultimate truth is, please understand, I am not giving you fantasy. I am not teaching you fantasy. I am teaching you reality. Even the life which is happening in your body is gift. Constantly you are showered. If you stand on this base, you can create wealth 10 times more. You can create infrastructure. See, if you start your life from the mood of not having, you will not create wealth, you will grab wealth. If you start your life feeling blessed, you will create wealth, you will not grab wealth. There's a big difference. Understand? I can say, I have given you the basic sutra of the whole N-Wealth program. This is what I go on expanding and making you feel as experience. If you start your life with the feeling, I don't have, you will grab, you will never create. You will be waiting for the opportunities to grab. Sometimes people tell me, Swamiji, I am completely content. I tell them, oh, that's great. If you get a lottery, $1 billion, will you say you don't want? No, no, no. Then what do you mean by you are completely content? No. Move from contentment to fulfillment. Fulfillment is totally different from contentment. You want to know what is the difference between two? Sit on N wealth. You will learn. If you start with idea of not having, I don't have, you will only grab. You will wait to grab. If you start with the reality, I am showered. Are still I am alive, my kidney is working, my liver is working, my brain is working at least once in a while. My heart is working. My lungs are working. So many things in our system is working. I am still feeling, I am alive. Millions of possibilities open the moment you feel that you are alive. See, like the moment you are out of this door, the millions of stars are seen. The millions of possibilities are opening up. Same way, the moment you feel you are alive, the millions of possibilities are opening. The door for the millions of possibility is the first experience. I am alive. Why don't you recognize that and celebrate? Understand, just a few days before we celebrated my enlightenment day, I am telling you very directly, all that happened on that day, I wanted to put it in a very plain words to you. I just recognized I am alive, and I realized that I am alive opens thousands of possibility in the realms of mysticism, in the realms of life, in the realms of physical health, mental health, wealth, knowledge, enlightenment, relationships. In every realm which you feel is essence of life or necessary for happy life, and finally being happy without anything, in all realms, I suddenly felt in each realm, thousands of possibilities are opening for me because I am alive. All I did is I recognized I am alive, and I realized thousands of possibilities opening in front of me. Billions of possibilities are open in front of me, and I started celebrating. That's all. See, recognizing I am alive is Sat, truth. Recognizing billions of possibilities are there in front of me is Chit, consciousness. Celebrating, wow, is Ananda. That's all. Just I experienced Satchidananda, the glimpse of Satchidananda on that day. That's what I call enlightenment. And just decide, today you will recognize you are alive. You are alive means what? Now millions of possibilities are opening in front of you. What million? Billion? What billion? Trillion. Possibilities are opening in front of you. You can be a good father or you can be a bad father. You can be a good brother or you can be a bad brother. You can be a good friend or you can be a bad friend. Or you can be healthy or you can be sick. But all are possibilities. thousands of possibilities are open in front of you is enough reason to celebrate. Understand? When you realize trillions of possibilities are open in front of you, you will become desireless. Please understand, I am cracking an important nut which keeps ignorance alive in you. I am cracking the head of the ignorance. If you are aware, trillions of possibilities are in front of you, you will not have desire. You will experience anashayam, means where not only there is desirelessness, the possibilities of desires gets burnt. You may think, how can it be? If there are billions of possibilities in front of me, naturally I'll be having so many desire to have this choice, that choice, that choice, that choice. No. When there is billions of possibilities in front of you, billions of choices in front of you, suddenly you feel like resting in choicelessness. The decision to rest in choicelessness, decision to relax in choicelessness happens when you see trillions of choices in front of you. When trillions of possibilities are in front of you, you just decide relaxing into choicelessness. You feel the ability to choose is more powerful, important, energetic, fulfilling than any choice you make. Please understand, the moment you start making choices, your freedom of being in choicelessness is getting restricted. The moment you choose, you will be choosing language. Now you are in a bondage of acting only in that language realm. Till you choose, you have a freedom of all languages. The moment you choose, you will take birth in India. Now you are bound by all the plus and minuses of this Indian society. Till you choose, you are beyond the plus and minuses of Indian society. Every choice you make takes away some part of being choiceless from you. So when there are trillions of choices in front of you, you suddenly decide, wow, being choiceless is the best thing. Being choiceless is the ultimate experience. The person who is being choiceless will be the infinite creator. Infinite creator. Please understand. Try resting in choicelessness. You will see the amount of wealth you will create, attract around you without grabbing. The technical term in the sutra is anashayam. Desirelessness. The essence, sacred secret in the sutra is relax into the space of gratitude. You are showered with so much. Trillions of choices are there in front of you. When you realize trillions of choices are there in front of you, you just relax in choiceless awareness. Just take few moments to remember, wow, I am alive. This is enough to open trillions of possibilities in front of me. Let me recognize I am alive. Let me recognize trillions of possibilities are there in front of me. Let me celebrate that Sat and Chit. Sit with this clarity of Satchitananda. Let this become your experience. In next few minutes, let this samyama happen in you. Now, just sit, remembering I am alive. Trillions of possibilities are there in front of me. Let me celebrate it. Close your eyes and just relax. I bless you all who are sitting with us at this moment around the world in 576 places through NTV, through two-way connection, 15 places, in 133 cities in 26 countries. I bless you all to achieve, experience, live, express, radiate and share the eternal bliss, Nityananda. Thank you.
Meditation, if this is we had a deep connection.